How's it going, everybody? My name's Mike Montgomery, and I just bought this house on 5 acres in beautiful Joshua Tree, California. I'm gonna be renovating this house completely over the next year or so, and I can't wait to share it with you guys. So let's get this tour started on Modern Builds. So I purchased the property for about $180,000, and that's a pretty good deal out here in Southern California. The house isn't huge, it's about 926 square feet, and it's one bed, one bath. This cabin was built in 1958, and it definitely shows. The exterior is super ugly, but I'm so excited to paint it a fresh color. Also, we've got single pane windows that need replaced, and pretty much every other finish outside. And if you're already a fan of Modern Builds, you may have noticed one other new thing, and it's not the house. It is the new gear. That's right, I am so excited to announce that I am partnering with Ariat to show off some of their clothing and workwear. For the past couple months, I have been wearing these Ariat boots, and I have been so impressed. These 8-inch tall work hog boots are comfortable, high quality, and they look amazing. And I'll be sure to leave a link down in the description to my landing page on Ariat's website where I show some of my favorite gear and what I've been wearing day to day. Now let's go tour inside. All right, so come on in. Now the first thing you're gonna notice about this house is every finish is going to need updated. I don't think this house has been remodeled since the mid 70s, and it shows. We've got acoustic ceilings, we've got equally ugly carpet, and it's all gotta go. Now there are a lot of upsides and downsides to this house. One of the downsides is the fact that we don't have central heat and air. So I'm gonna be taking out this window unit, patching up this wall, and I'm gonna be installing a DIY ductless mini split unit. One receiver will be here in the living room and the other receiver will be in the bedroom. That way I can have some electric heat and get off this fireplace. I've got no interest in having a fireplace be my primary heat in the winter. I grew up having a fireplace and it sucks loading and cutting and storing wood, it's no fun. So I'm gonna be getting rid of this fireplace, like I mentioned, gaining all of this square footage. That way I can have a proper wall that I can have a sofa on here. It's gonna be great. Oh, and not to mention, this mantle isn't flat and the stone is really ugly. So I know the insert is kind of cool, but I don't think it has enough charm to keep. Don't hate me though. All right, moving on to the other half of this living room, or the living area, we have what's technically the dining room. And for a house that's only 928 square feet, this is a really large space. So my big plan is to take out this wall. Now, I don't know if this is load bearing or not yet. I'm gonna talk to some contractors, but I would love to take out this wall and extend the kitchen out just a little bit. If it eats into this dining room space some, that's totally fine for me. I'll still have plenty of room for a 6-person table and it'll function really well. But the addition of having a proper kitchen island is totally worth it. Okay, moving on, I'm gonna show you my favorite part of the house. I don't mean to brag, but this is my hallway. This is the whole thing. Okay, it's not much of a hallway, but you do have the option of going 3 directions from here. You can either go into the kitchen, the bathroom, or the 1 bedroom that this house has. The other houses that were similar square footage actually had 2 bedrooms and 1 bath, but I opted for this house. It's got a little bit more room in the living areas and a little extra square footage here in the bedroom. This isn't a huge space, but it's plenty of room for a good queen bed, which is fine for me. And it's even got a decent amount of closet space, which will be a really fun makeover and project. I really love the fact that we've got a lot of windows in this space, even though they are single pane and will eventually need replaced. Here in the bedroom, we've got a little bit of linen storage. I think this is gonna be convenient. It's not anything crazy, but we'll turn it into something cool. All right, moving on. I wanna show you guys what is the most standard bathroom in the world. I think you've probably seen about 1,000 that look like this. We've got ugly, fake parquet floors, an old acorn-colored shower insert, and I think the ugliest vanity I've ever seen. The good news is, these are the perfect before shots for the videos that I'm gonna make renovating this space. My big plan is to do 2 renovations in this space. The first one is a weekend, budget-friendly renovation where I'm gonna be updating as much as I can, building a cool light fixture and medicine cabinet. I think I'm gonna paint the actual shower insert. I've seen people do it and I'm really curious to see how well it works. And then after a few months, once I've been able to move into the place and I'm comfortable, I'll do the real renovation where I tear this puppy apart. But enough of the bathroom, let's skip over to the kitchen. It's not very far away. So remember, I want to take out this wall, and you can imagine how much more light and just general open feeling is going to be achieved by doing that. I also want to update these cabinets and appliances. These are original to the house in 1958. They still actually work great. Shout out to General Electric for making good products, but they're not exactly trendy. So I want to take out the counters. I want to take out the appliances, the fixtures, and update everything. In the kitchen, I'm going to be doing two renovations just like the bathroom. In the first one, I just want to clean up the cabinets, give them a fresh paint job, and then update countertops, things like that. In the second big renovation, I'm gonna be building cabinets from scratch. So I think I've got my 2021 planned out. Moving on, you are gonna find what is the messiest part of the house. I had to bring in some boxes and tools, and I put them into the laundry room addition. So forgive the mess. The upside of this laundry room is that it's an addition, and it doesn't count towards the actual square footage of the house. So this is all additional space that I almost get for free. We've got laundry on this side, and there's quite a bit of space. I think this will be a great makeover video. But the cool part is this laundry room has the exact same amount of space on the opposite wall. There's a lot of room here to make a mudroom. I think some kind of cool storage solution will be a fun project for the space. As you can tell, even though this was built later, they used diarrhea green paint, and we've got plenty of updating to do. Now, the next thing I want to show you is the backyard, but before I do, I want to give a big thanks to the sponsor of today's episode, Squarespace. If you're in need of a website, an online store, or a custom domain, look no further than squarespace.com. Squarespace has a beautiful all-in-one platform where you can build your own website with zero website building experience. Squarespace's library of built-in designer templates look incredible right out of the gate. All you need to be able to do to customize your website is drag and drop files and edit text and image blocks. Also, Squarespace sites are optimized to look great on desktop, tablet, and mobile, no matter where your customers find you. Now, I have hosted the Modern Builds website for over 4 years on Squarespace, long before they were a sponsor. I loved their service then, and I could not be more proud or happy to recommend them to you guys now. And right now, if you follow the link in my description, squarespace.com/modernbuilds, you can design your entire Squarespace site without entering any of your credit card info. And then when it's time for your website to go live, don't forget to check out using the code modernbuilds for 10% off your first site. One more time, that's squarespace.com/modernbuilds, and the discount code is modernbuilds. Now let's get back to this house tour. So you have officially seen the inside of the house, and it's not huge, but we're gonna have some great content, a lot of ugly befores for some really cool afters. Now this is what is the back porch currently. It's not very large, and I wanna blow out that back wall and extend the pad all the way to the edge of the house. But this is where I see myself grilling and chilling mostly. Right now it's just storage for some extra materials, and we are currently on the side of the house that we started on. And if you follow me, we can check out the backyard. Now this is the only flat part of the property with no trees, no bushes or shrubs, but it does have this giant school bus. I just got done converting this into a tiny house, and if you want to check out the transformation, I will leave a link to the playlist down in the description. There's just enough space that this fits in the backyard. I love the fact that it's already fenced in, and even though this is chain link, I've got a great idea for a YouTube video where I'll be converting this chain link fence into a wooden privacy fence. It should be really, really fun. Now, we're about to go this way to the other side of the property because I want to show you a couple of the cool parts of these 5 acres that I got. This is totally the upside of having land and getting out of the neighborhood. I'm going to be able to spread out, I'm going to build cool projects, and I don't have to worry about the neighbors putting in noise complaints. So the property comes with this really neat old shed. As you can tell, it's a little battered, it's a little, let's just say, rustic. But this is gonna be my first workshop on the property. Me and Brett, who's my filmer currently, just got done pouring this concrete floor, and overall it came out nice. But as you can tell, I've got a decent sized space that I'll be able to build in and renovate out of until I get a full shop built, which is on the list. I'm gonna be taking out all of these ugly cabinets, I'm gonna be raising these beams to get a little bit more headroom, and I'm gonna line the interior walls with plywood. That way I can mount anything I want, anywhere I want. This is gonna be a project video very soon. As you can tell, we've already got it started, and I can't wait to show it. And this is where I'm gonna be putting in my permanent shop. Before I bought this land, somebody paid to get this entire hill excavated. I'm gonna assume for the same reason I want it excavated. But what this means is I don't have to worry about removing Joshua trees, which is apparently illegal to do, and I don't have to pay somebody to do all this excavation work. So my next steps are to find a metal building supplier who wants to gift me a metal building in exchange for some really great content. Once I can get that figured out, I want to put a building on this space, something that's maybe 40 by 50 or 40 by 60. This will give me that workshop that I've always wanted. I won't need anything larger, nothing that I have to grow into. It'll be the bomb. But let's check out some more of the property. What I love about the space is that we've got all the Joshua trees. Like, check out that one right there. I'm talking a lot of Joshua trees. And I'm not just talking about a couple of Joshua trees. They are everywhere. And I couldn't be more excited about it. I love this land. I love being out here in Southern California. And I even looked at a couple of neighborhood lots while I was house hunting. But what I ended up deciding is I would much rather have land for the reasons I mentioned and because I'm in such a unique place. I've come a long way from Oklahoma, so I really want to take advantage of the natural beauty out here in Joshua Tree. And that concludes our property tour, and I really hope you enjoyed it. I already know there has to be a few things that I missed, like these trees. I totally forgot to point out these trees. They are so tall and probably a little too close to the house, but I'm happy to have them for now. So I have no idea what to expect. This is by far the biggest project I have undertaken, but I am so excited for it. I turned 25 this year and I've been out in California now for about 3, and I have decided that this is where I want to be for the next little while. I enjoy the desert, the nature is beautiful, plus the weather is always nice and conducive to filming. So far, this 5-year YouTube journey has been unpredictable, exciting, and pretty much the best job I ever could have asked for. But now that I've got this place and I'm looking forward to what 2021 has in store, I really expect this to be the best year of modern builds yet. If you're not already, follow me on Instagram to stay up to date with what I'm doing, and don't forget to click the subscribe button and the notification bell. That way you stay updated every time I post new videos. Seriously, guys, thank you so much for following me along on this journey. I cannot wait to start tearing this place apart and sharing it with you guys. And finally, I want to give one more huge thanks to Squarespace and Ariat for sponsoring this content. And we'll see you next time on Modern Builds. Bye, everybody.